as the Nazis were about to enter Paris, my father was very undecided as to whether he should take in the entire family and traveling to the United States, emigrating from France. He was very misupik, he was very much in doubt what he should do. He went to the Rebbe, and he asked the Rebbe, what's the Rebbe's opinion? And the Rebbe said, "Yizayin techa chosid, shikta briv dem Rebbe." Send a letter or a telegram to my father-in-law, the Rebbe, Friedrich Rebbe. My father said, "Well, but there's a war going on now. It's impossible. There's no communication between Poland and France. No letters are crossing the border, and I doubt whether there are any telegrams or telephones that can be made." And the Rebbe said, "As a chassid, you should know that the Rebbe does not necessarily have to receive a letter or a telephone to know the question that you're answering, and you don't necessarily have to receive a telegraph or a letter or a telephone from the Rebbe to know what the answer is."
As we bald as a do a gwul gashmi, a hefse gashmi, so am verdruf nit nispol werden, und mit weiter stehen bekischer wie gewen frie. Und nit nur der Kischer soll gehen von ihm zu den Jiden, mit welche seine gewen seine, edere Arriber geformt im gwul. Nur reiche der Kischer soll konne non gehen von See zu ihm, auf all Piva See seine nit bedarger Schelei. Und bei sie ist Mokim, Mokim bepeil, amafsik und marchik bechulhu.
When we first came to Amherst, we decided that we'd make a concert as part of the dedication of the Chabad house. We arranged with the University of Massachusetts that we would be able to use the new concert hall in their new fine arts center. And we began publicizing the event, and I spared nothing in terms of expense, both in terms of the Theodore Raquel who we hired and the band, and we did television advertising and radio advertising, and we sent out beautiful brochures. So the Friday before the concert, like about an hour before Shabbos, I called up to the ticket office to find out how many tickets were finally sold. Lady says, "Let me check." She comes back, the phone, and she says, 87. I said, no, we're talking about the concert this Sunday. She says, "Yeah, with Theodore McKelly." I said, yeah, that one, 87. It was like, it's an hour before Shabbos. There's nothing more that can be done. And that's it. I remember Shabbos afternoon. I'm thinking to myself, it's like 5 months on Shlichas and already to have such a disaster. I mean, and as I'm standing there and looking there, I reminded myself of a story that I had heard about Reb Mendel Futterfass, who had been arrested and sent to Siberia.
My Zayde, Reb Mendel Futterfass, was arrested in 1946. He was sitting in his cell thinking about, where am I? Where's my wife? Where are my children? And thinking about the family, that's when he started feeling how bad the matzav is. As he's thinking, he reminds himself of the last time he saw the Friedrich Rebbe. He was by the Verbringung of the Friedrich Rebbe, and the Friedrich Rebbe spoke about his leaving Russia and said, "Ihr trachten wegen mir, wir trachten wegen euch." He started thinking about the Rebbe, and he started thinking the way he's writing opinion. When he came out of Russia in Tovshin Chav Daled, my grandmother had shown him all the letters that she had received from the Friedrich Rebbe, and she showed him one specific letter. This is a letter not to the family, not to my grandmother. It's a letter to my grandfather personally. And the letter said, "Hamivrak Niskabel." He spotted the date of the letter. The date was the first day he was put into jail. He was thinking about the Friedrich Rebbe. He's thinking, well, he's writing a pidyon, asking for a bracha, and the Friedrich Rebbe is answering the letter, "Hamivrak Niskabel."
Die, was am gewollt haben, dem Käse. I das gewähnt, wie früher, wie andere, wie noch bei Jesser Seis und bei Jesser Reis. בזמן את הפזיפיל הסנית גבליב מרנית ועניינים רוחניים, לורצי ידעו פון סיפורים פון כמה מנשן ועניינים עושים זה חוגטון. דור דם רב דם נוסי בייסים עבר לגבול מכאן, אף על פי ודוס עוד גדב זין לחיירי די שטט לספונינה וגפינצר דוטן על עשר אין מוקים גשו.
I was thinking to myself, the Mendelfot of us, who had sent a pigeon to the Rebbe b'machshavet, if I was only a chosid, that's what I would do right now. I would send a letter to the Rebbe, 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 save me. I woke up Sunday morning and I give a look up at the plaza towards the Fine Arts Center, and there are lines of people standing there waiting to buy tickets for this concert. Turns out over 1,000 people showed up for the concert. My Bubba was there. And right after the concert, she went to New York, to Yechidus. My grandmother said to the Rebbe, Chkumitzter von Amherst, from the concert. The Rebbe said, Nu, und wie viel Menschen gewesen? How many people were there? So my Bubba said, Über 1,000. And the Rebbe said, Über 1,000, more than 1,000. Nechten is Yisrael given as they marish here. And yesterday Yisrael was so worried.
I das nicht wie mir kon sorgen wie der was will gucken mehr nicht wie bei eine Bosser und nicht nur Bosser Gashmi nur ihr Bosser Chumi. Als sie geworden hast, wie schaue ma hässig, wie hulhu, nor do se eme do mishamish ma kan ma shom af at. Guazevi so demot ne gikon uftor, der bal korche von dem Arishik und von dem Mokim Gashmi, in der zweiten Mokim Gashmi, azei konechit ne tuftor, ner der bal korche, in der Mini von der Hefzig bischass er allein hat auch gepasst und auf sich dem Dien, als der Hefzig von der Gwul soll ihm nicht mafzig sein, auf zu tun mit den Iden, welche er hat mechander gewonnen, welche er hat aufgestellt und die, was will ihm amtschig sein, gehen bedroht.